Okay, Coach Breeze, so 6-4 with Ashlyn. You got a swing match. You lose in overtime. But let's talk about the fight with Orson.
Yeah.
He battled back, right?
Yeah, we've seen that from him most of the year. He's had a couple little, like, freshman blips along the way. But, I mean, honestly, his first college match, he got mixered to his back, fought off of his back, and came back and majored the guy. And that's when we knew we were going to be all right with him. He's got fight. He's competitive. He just sometimes doesn't turn the compete on early enough. He wants it to be easy in the first period sometimes instead of making the match his. And then second, third period kind of taking over. He does a lot of coming back right now.
Okay, so I look at the 1-2 punch, Blake and Forrest.
Yep.
Right out of the gate, man. I don't think this is one of the last times you're ever going to have him. Right? You got one more.
Yeah.
But that 1-2 punch, those are two guys I think that nobody wants to wrestle them in that day tournament.
Yeah, they're coming on at the right time. And obviously, Blake's been hurt for a while, but it was great to see him. He did not wrestle at all like himself, nor were we probably 100% ready at GMAC Duels. He did what he needed to do for the team because we felt like we needed that match at 25. Looked 1,000,000% better this week. Looks like himself again. And so I think we're only going to be getting better as we get to the regional tournament because he kind of started over the last couple of weeks. And then Forrest, it's exciting because he's starting to find ways to win matches. He's always had pace. He's always been a guy that was going to surge on you in the third. But sometimes he did a little too much and he would dig himself a hole or he would find a way to lose because he was trying too hard. He's starting to have a lot more awareness of where he's at, when to push, when to not, and that's exciting to see.
They're Indiana guys that wrestle like PA guys. Dad's from PA.
Yes.
And I was like, man, these dudes wrestle like PA guys. That's all I could think in my mind. And then the dad came up to me and talked to me last week at the GMAC Duels, and he's like, oh, yeah, my brother in Pennsylvania is watching. But now it all makes sense, right? They wrestle like that. Speaking of PA, I don't know if I said this right, but I know you're a 2-time Pennsylvania State champ.
Correct.
Once as a freshman.
Correct.
And then junior year.
Correct.
Okay, I got it right. Said it, I announced it, yeah. I got it from McGuffey, right?
From McGuffey, yep.
Okay, I nailed it. I feel better about that, right? Okay, so going on the stretch, Boggs.
Yeah.
Boggs does what Boggs does, right? But here's the thing with Boggs. Boggs could have a tough regional tournament. All your guys could have a tough regional tournament. I mean, your regional is ridiculous.
It's brutal.
I mean, there's going to be guys sitting at home who would be finalist threats.
Yeah, for sure.
I don't feel like an idiot saying that.
No, I mean, you can look at the rankings. I mean, and if you believe enough in rankings that tells you who the best guys in the country are right now, if you do or don't believe that, but if you believe that, we will leave all Americans home at nearly every weight.
What's the formula for getting half the team, 5 guys to Cleveland for the NCAAs?
I don't even know if there is a formula for 5 guys. I don't think you can predict something like that. I think the biggest thing is it's going to be an emotional roller coaster, and you have to go in composed and know that you're going to – almost every match is going to be a dogfight, and be willing to accept that. Don't think you're going to luck your way into anything. And at the end of the day, it really doesn't matter if you win the dang thing or – I had a coach that always told me it didn't matter if you rode in on a Harley or you pedaled into Huffy, you were going to the state tournament. Same idea. It doesn't matter how you get there. Be willing to be that guy late in the day. It's only a 1-day tournament, which I think is great for us. So 1 day, grind. We feel like we're a pretty gritty team most of the time. We certainly weren't tonight in some areas, but as a whole, I think we're a pretty gritty team. So a long, hard day, I think benefits us, and so we like that. But I mean, you've been around this long enough, there's no way to put a formula or predict it. You freaking go fight your butt off, hope you get a break or two, and try and put yourself in the best position possible. There's no way to predict it. We could take 10 guys, we could take 2, and we could have a good day doing either of those and not get a couple of breaks.
That's crazy. So much parody, I love.
Yeah.
All right, dinner and a show Wednesday, I'll be here. What should I expect?
I think it's going to be really awesome. It's a very unique event. We're going to have dinner tables around the mat. We're going to have our season ticket holders lined up. So it's going to be kind of a pit around the mat, benches on the opposite side, gladiator style with all the general admission people up above yelling down. It's the perfect mix of we're trying to have a really classy event, and we got people up in the top being idiots screaming and yelling.
Where is it?
It's going to be over in our multi-purpose gym.
So it's going to be the balcony. People are going to be screaming down from the balcony?
People are going to be screaming down from the balcony.
Dude, you got me fired up now. It's Urbana, right?
Urbana, yep. You got people eating spare ribs by the mat, people screaming up above. It's such a cool event, and it will grow. We didn't sell as many tickets as we wanted this year. People are going to see it this year and go, I want to be a part of that next year, and it will continue to grow. It's really, really cool.
I'm pumped. You got anything else for me?
No, I think that's it. Actually, I do. I don't know how much is really out there about this, and don't necessarily want to put too much family business out there, but we'll just kind of leave it as Coach Hoogenboom and his family, the godfather of this program. They have some family people that are not feeling so well right now, and just any thoughts and prayers with him. He could really use it. I mean, this man built everything. I'm just steering the ship that he built, so... anybody that knows him, wants to reach out, thoughts and prayers to him would be much appreciated.
Shouted him out on the broadcast a couple of times.
Awesome.
Call him he's the man who built it from nothing to what it is.
Call him the Godfather.
The Godfather. All right, hey, thanks for the time. See you Wednesday.
Yes.